Are we getting a completely new Justice League film from Joss Whedon? With an extra $25 million spent, as well as 2 months of reshoots, word has been circulating that Joss Whedon's influence on Justice League is not just limited to a few post-production final touches. And now we seem to be getting confirmation of these rumors with fresh reports that entire characters are being overhauled by the Avengers director, specifically Cyborg. In a recent interview with IGN, actor Joe Morton, who plays Cyborg's father, hinted that Cyborg might be getting a lighter character shift, which confirms the rumors that Joss's changes to the film are more intensive than just adding a few zingers. Now, when we heard earlier this year that Zack Snyder had brought Joss Whedon on board to write additional dialogue for some scenes, we thought it would just be a few dialogue punch-ups. Nothing too crazy, just giving DC a little bit of that Whedon magic. Hey, yeah. Then news came that Snyder was stepping down and Joss was taking over directing duties. Now, this came as a bit of a shock since Justice League seemed so close to wrapping. Despite the abrupt change, Warner Brothers reassured Snyder fans by insisting that whatever Joss did would have to adhere to the style and tone and the template that Zack set, making it sound like Joss was there to finish checking off the boxes on Zack's finished Justice League to-do list. However, it appears those Justice League reshoots were a little more intensive than that press release led us to believe, with leaked set pics seemingly featuring the Hall of Justice as part of Whedon's take. From what we know, the inclusion of the Hall of Justice definitely wasn't in Snyder's version and harkens back to the lighthearted Super Friends era of the JL. Off the heels of those reshoots, Wonder Woman smashed the box office, forcing WB to rethink their DCEU strategy, both in terms of character and tone. Now, we've seen these changes already in the most recent trailer, with Wonder Woman front and center and the rest of the league trading Whedon-esque quips and barbs. Another twist was Joss Whedon switching composers on us, shifting from the gritty, metal-inspired riffs of Junkie XL to the more orchestral, whimsical style of seasoned superhero film composer Danny Elfman. Now, this was another change which supported the film's transition from Snyder's darker tone to Whedon's lighter one. So that brings us to the current character changes and what pretty much confirms the full Whedon takeover of the film. In that interview, Morton revealed that Cyborg's tone had been lightened up after the studio felt initial cuts of the Justice League were too dark. However, we did see some humor from The Flash in the most recent trailer that dropped at Comic-Con, so we're thinking the Cyborg reshoots will bring the cybernetic character closer to The Flash's lighthearted energy, maybe having him be the balance point between Batman's seriousness and Barry Allen's playful quips. Either way, it sounds like a definite departure from the horror-like origin scene Zack Snyder gave us in Batman v Superman. But what do you folks think? Will Joss Whedon's updates make for a better Justice League movie? And would you want a funnier or more serious Cyborg? Let's discuss. And do you love Game of Thrones? If you want more Westeros drama, be sure to check out our live GOT after show, All Kings Considered. We break down the latest episode, dissect the theories, and predict what's next for the Seven Kingdoms. You can catch it every Monday at 1 p.m. Pacific on YouTube or ProjectAlpha.com.